Thank you. I appreciate you being here this evening. For the past 7 years, I've been the criminal district attorney of Zandt County, and I've worked with a very conservative mindset. Been physically responsible, making sure that I am making the office better than I found it. Be that in ways of justice programs, be that in ways of personnel, be that in ways of developing working relationships with the county. And something that I've gotten to do as your criminal district attorney is bring in new personnel. And when I do that, I interview people and I do it with a mindset. I'm looking for someone who not only looks great on paper, but fits into Zandt County. Someone who's got the right culture, someone who's got the right philosophies, someone's got the right ideologies, someone who's got work ethic, someone who's willing to go the extra mile. And so I wouldn't be hiring those people into the Zandt County DA's office and then standing up here and asking you to hire me on May 22nd as your district judge of the 294 judicial district. So with that in mind, I've been very conservative in the way that I've gone about prosecuting criminal cases. I'm uniquely qualified because I've been working in this district court for the last 7 years. I've worked in every office in the county, okay? When I say I've worked in every office, I have had contacts with every office. I'm a 14-year county government employee. I started as a clerk in law school, collecting my checks, working my way up within the Zandt County system. I know the judicial system. I know Zandt County. I'm a 40-year resident. I've been married for 18 years in June. I'm raising my kids here because I grew up here. Zandt County is important to me. I know it's important to you, and if you will entrust me with your voting, you will stand with me, and I can promise you that you will be happy about your decision for the next 4 years.
Remember, applause is okay on the opening. Oh, so good. Ms. Brumbelow, 2 minutes.
Can you guys hear me now? Thanks, Tom. Good evening. My name is Tina Brumbelow, and as many of you know, I reside in Zandt, Texas with my husband and family. I thank you so much for being here tonight and giving me the opportunity to be your runoff candidate for the district court here in Zandt County. It's an obstacle that I did not think that I would overcome with no name recognition and no very few people in this particular county. However, obstacles are something that I do not take lightly. In fact, I was born to a 15-year-old mother, fatherless until the age of 4, and due to a very broken home, was raised by the guiding influence of my grandparents. I have both the life and legal experience that no other candidate offers for this particular position. At a very young age, I was also diagnosed with a rare hearing loss. I was considered to be profoundly deaf. Not only did my hearing loss allow me to acquire speech, it also allowed me to hear, just like you guys did with hearing aids. Despite all these obstacles that I've faced in my life, I've excelled both in schooling, at work, and my extracurricular activities. I was the first in my family to go to college and graduate. I was also the first in my family to attend a professional school, such as law school. While in law school, I became the first deaf advocate for South Texas College of Law, which is nationally known. I also became the first deaf intern for the 14th Court of Appeals and worked with former Judge Richard Davis here in Canton, Texas. I became the first person in 2001 that was deaf to graduate from South Texas College of Law, and also the first deaf person, one of the first deaf people to become a trial attorney that same year. The one thing that I hear from people is they want a stronger, better district court system than what they have. I want to expand upon the amazing programs that Judge Drum put in place, including the recoupment of court-appointed attorney's fees and collection of child support, and implement new programs such as a veterans court. So, Tina Brumbelow on May the 22nd.
Okay, our questioning will start. Remember, 1 minute. If the question is to both of you, you'll each have 1 minute to answer the question, and then 30 seconds for rebuttals. Let me know with the hand signal if you want to rebut what the other candidate said. Ken will ask the first question.
Okay, this question is for both of you. We wanted to start it off on a good note. What do you admire most about your opponent? this is what I admire the most about Tina. She's very positive. She's not one to run around and be woe is me, as you can hear from her introduction. So throughout this campaign, I've told Tina on more than one occasion, publicly, that I've enjoyed this race. Elections are hard, they're difficult on your families, and they can be made even more so if someone on the other side is ruthless, without an ethics. And that's not Tina Brumbelow. So that's something that I enjoy about her, that she is a true professional, and I think she's really.
Thank you. I guess
one
of the main things I can admire about Chris Martin is probably the support of his wife and the support of his children. I say that because they have gone through great battles of back him. At the last debate that we had, Chris kind of left out his kids to help me put out cards. And I say that because most opponents wouldn't allow their kids to put out cards for their opponents. And his son was so happy to help me, and they've been so nice to me. So I'm admiring the amazing game that he had back in support.
Rebecca, go ahead.
That is not the first time that I've heard my wife.
Thank you. Next question will be to both of y'all, starting with Ms. Brumbelow. What makes you more qualified to serve as district judge than your opponent?
Well, actually, I was pregnant today, and I had more than 20 years of legal experience. My legal experience actually started back when I was prosecuted for the chief court in high school. Then I went on through law school and worked 45 jobs clerking while I was in law school to get through it. Since then, I've been licensed to practice over 17 years in the state of Texas, 13 of which I've had my own law firm. Not only have I practiced criminal defense work, I've also practiced general civil litigation, which is everything from property disputes all the way to election disputes. I haven't had that, but I've had some very highly contested personal injury cases, and I also have a significant amount of experience in family law. It's very important to recognize that family law encompasses more than 50% of this court's time, and you need to have somebody that knows that particular area, everything from divorces to terminations to child custody.
Mr. Martin, same question.
I believe I'm more qualified than Ms. Brumbelow because I've been given to this community for the past 7 years as an elected criminal district attorney that has inside look of the Zandt County criminal justice system. I've been working in that district for the last 7 years. I know what makes it tick. I know what makes it stop. I know how the grand jury gets impaneled. I know how quickly the cases go through the grand jury. I know the criminal defense bar. I know the family bar. I know what lawyers delay cases. I know how they delay cases. I know what procedures and methods need to be put in place to safeguard that. I know the tricks that the state will employ to slow down a case. So I'm more qualified in that regard because I've got the experience. I've been doing this. I didn't just show up in November and file. This is something that I've been praying about for over a year and a half. And I know that I am unequivocally prepared to do this job.
Go ahead.
It's very interesting. I just didn't show up in November to do this job either. In fact, my first hearing I ever had in my legal career was before Judge Wallace in the 294 Judicial District Court. So I had 17 years worth of experience at the 294, in which I believe I'm most qualified to be a judge.
Go ahead.
We're going to plug him up at all.
I'll stop it.
The current, Ms. Brumbelow's current caseload in Zandt County is 27 cases. That's 27 civil and family together. Someone who's been here for a number of years, who's been involved in the community. I think she showed up in November to run for district judge. She wasn't here before that. Zero criminal cases, ever prosecuted, ever defended in Zandt County. So I don't think she has the Zandt County experience. I think she has the Smith County experience where she chooses to do her work.
Go ahead.
In fact, I don't just choose to do my work in Smith County. I do my work all over the state of Texas. All the way from Harris County to Wichita Falls to West Texas and East Texas. I'm not only licensed to practice in state court, but I'm also licensed to practice in federal court. So my job does not keep me here in Zandt County. It allows me to see other court systems as well, to see how the Zandt County court system can be ran more efficiently based upon how others do it. And my current caseload might be 27. I have no good idea what my current caseload is, but he did talk about the ones that I had before that being.
Okay, we're going to move on to the next question. Ken?
This is for both of you. Mr. Martin, you be first. How would you specifically reduce the backlog of cases and improve the efficiency of the district court? And would you transfer felony cases to the county court of law to balance caseloads? Why or why not?
The way that I would improve efficiency in the district court is to prioritize the serious cases, serious criminal cases, serious civil cases, wrongful death, serious family law cases where you have divorces with alleged family violence. I would prioritize those because those are the cases that have the most consequences. Those are the cases that need to be moved. I would prioritize those. I would work hand in hand with the state of Texas on identifying the most pressing criminal cases that need to be tried. I would be willing to discuss with the family attorneys, the civil attorneys, to get any type of case docking priority schedule set, because you have to rely on these men and women who are practicing law, because you tap their experience and they can help you understand things that you might not understand from a judicial perspective. I think I have 30 seconds.
Balance the case loads.
Yes, I would work hand in hand with Judge Joshua in balancing the case load, wherever it may be, whether it's county court of law coming up to the district court or the district court going down to the county court of law. There needs to be harmony, there needs to be reciprocity and a working relationship between those two courts. And Joshua Winters and I have been doing that and will continue doing that.
Ms. Brumbelow, would you like the question again? Okay.
Actually, the case law can be reduced both by working